All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome into Monday Night Show. And typically, we'd be focusing on the entire offense on a Monday evening after a football game, especially one where as many yards and excitement was put up. And despite this being a JT Daniels-only show tonight, considering Georgia managed to rush for only 8 yards on 23 attempts, and Daniels went for, you know, four touchdowns and 400 yards, a 400 burger, a nice easy one through the air, accounting for quite literally 98% of the offense. I guess you could say it's business as usual tonight. I mean, he's 98% of the offense. This is an offensive-specific breakdown on Monday night typically, and boom, here we go with JT Daniels being asked to turn up the mic here. Maybe I'll just move it closer or speak louder. Yeah, that's right. Just less than 10 days after I came on the airways and attempted to maybe temper your expectations, the young man goes out and sets a single, sets five single-game career highs, yards, 401, touchdowns, four, completion percentage, 73.7, yards per attempt, 10.55. I mean, he quite literally had the best game of his life on Saturday night, played phenomenally. And, you know, that's all a testament to him. It's been 15 months since he last saw live bullets, and he was flat-out electric. Think about that. 15 months, not ever getting tackled, not ever getting hit, but just going out there and practicing over and over again and getting in thousands and thousands of reps. But that's always been the thing here. It was never about talent with JT Daniels. Even if you watched the film breakdown that we did earlier, you know, just 10 days ago, it was always there. You know, it was just a matter of consistency, whether it was possible, you know, going to continue to pop up over and over again. If the mechanics were consistent over and over again, he was going to be great if he was consistent. He was mighty consistent on Saturday night. The other thing is, you got to give this Todd Monken staff a lot of credit. Look, he's been there 6 months, and he's clearly gotten better in the last 6 months, even though it's all been behind closed doors. The kid comes out and sets a career high in the SEC against, whether or not you want to call it, a pretty decent Mississippi State defense, had the run game completely taken away from him. The guy played lights out, and he's gotten much, much better. That's a credit to Monken and that staff. And the other thing is, guys, he is a Todd Monken quarterback. He is. Think about this. Everything in Todd Monken's system is about being aggressive and driving the ball down the field. We get, you know, some nice, easy completions early in the football game, and then we begin to open it up and drive the ball down the field. Remember, think about the last 3 years that he was an offensive coordinator, whether or not he was calling plays or not in Cleveland, he still had the offensive identity wrapped in him. Think of the last 3 years in the NFL as an offensive coordinator. His best year was when he had Ryan Fitzpatrick, who, guys, I don't know if y'all have ever watched him play. He's got zero fear of driving the ball down the field. And a guy by the name of Jameis Winston. They threw for almost 5,000 yards with Jameis Winston as a quarterback. So this is his style of guy, one that has absolutely zero fear driving the ball down the field and giving his wide receivers a chance. Another thing about Monken, people fail to realize that, yeah, he's done a great job of this quarterback room in terms of at least JT developing him and making him even better and more consistent. But this is a former wide receivers coach, guys. What do you think an offensive coordinator whose background is as a wide receivers coach is going to prefer? Is he going to prefer the quarterback that always gives his wide receiver a chance, even if he's semi-covered, like JT did all night Saturday night? Or is he going to, you know, prefer Charlie Checkdown, who's always worried about protecting the football? He had that with Baker Mayfield. Didn't go so hot. Now Baker's in an offense that's run heavy, you know, clear checks, you know, wide open here, hit it, or, you know, get rid of the ball, okay? This is a totally different offense. He wants to drive the ball down the field and with quarterbacks that are going to do so. The difference was JT Daniels protected the football for the most part on Saturday night. Look, he made one bad decision on the very fourth play of the game, guys. Fourth play of the game, he throws a very, very interceptable football. It is dropped by number three for Mississippi State. The very next play, he gets hit for the first time and is sacked. After that, again, lights out. Great game by JT Daniels, and it was there the whole time, right? The consistency was always going to be the question. All right, 5 minutes of a nice long monologue. I know people are here for the tape. They're not here for me to run my mouth, but you get both when you show up here, if you haven't noticed already. But I appreciate you guys for being here on a Monday night. We've got an exciting one, obviously. This is by far the best quarterback play Georgia's had in you know, a long time, right? Eight or nine years since Aaron Murray left. He was the last real kind of guy that could rack up the stats, but he did it in a totally different way. It wasn't near this electric. I'll tell you that much right now. So let's jump right into the tape. No more wasted time. All right. So you'll notice very early on in this football game that Todd Monken took it upon himself to get this young man comfortable. Okay. Starts with an open or opens the game with a run. I believe his first five passes were within 5 yards or fewer. Okay. Really getting the ball out of his hands early, letting this kid get his feet wet. First time playing ball in, you know, 15 months. So what's he do? He comes out, gets him a nice, easy touch. Now, doesn't really go for much on this first rundown play, but we're not here to watch those. We're here to watch him throw the football, which is what happens right here. He sees the corner back off, and he knows immediately he's working the hitch. Boom. Get him a nice, easy, quick game pass. Let George do all the rest out of the back, or, you know, after the catch. This is one thing I like about what Daniels did. Early in the football game, he was throwing nice, catchable, and runnable footballs for these wide receivers to go make plays. And again, this is that offensive coordinator, that experienced offensive coordinator getting in here and say, okay, guy hadn't played in a while. Let's not only put him in a pistol set where he's naturally more comfortable. Okay, well, we watched a lot of that USC tape when he was handing the ball off, when he was doing play action, he was doing it from the pistol set. Georgia ran more pistol to open this football game than they have all season. That is not a coincidence. That is a savvy offensive coordinator walking in on Monday saying, son, it's your job. What do we need to do to make you most comfortable? What do you like in this offense? And Daniels, being the smart guy that he is, whips out the playbook and says, coach, I like this, 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 and this, and I'm most comfortable in these formations. Okay, let's make a game plan. Then they watch the tape and go attack it, just like that. All right, that's how those things work. Now, they come out, get him nice and comfortable again, and don't ask him to drive the ball down the field just yet. Let him hand the ball off, even to no avail. We'll talk about that more tomorrow. But here's the bad decision, okay? Maybe staring down, making the preconception or making the decision pre-snap, not reading and reacting post-snap, and it about cost him four plays in, okay? So we made our first bad decision, right? Now, quarterbacks will tell you, offensive linemen will tell you it's different, obviously, for them because they're not the sole reason a play sometimes is successful and a complete catastrophe. So guys will tell you that first time you get hit really, really hard when you haven't played in a long time, that one wakes you up and snaps you back into it, gets the adrenaline flowing, and you stop thinking so much. The first, like, missed assignment, blown assignment, that's going to wake you up. You're going to be like, okay, I'm here now. Let's go. Same thing for a quarterback. He said it after the game. The first time he made a mistake, he was like, okay, now I'm back into football. The first bad throws out, we made our first bad decision, and that was the last bad decision I felt that he had made all night. Very next play, this is somehow fitting for this kid at this point. He makes his first bad decision, hadn't been hit yet in the football game, and the very next play, he gets sacked and gets kind of crumpled up on both those knees, pops right back up, runs to the sideline, comes back to the next possession, and starts getting a little freaky, okay? Where are we going next? We're going to 126. We're already on it. All right, he can count really well, okay? When he brings the running back in down here and he sees 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, guy hanging over 7, two safeties at, 10 yards, and George Pickens out here one-on-one with a 7-yard, 8-yard cushion. Yeah, he's pretty smart, guys. He's going to take that 9 times out of 7, okay? He's going to abort the fake entirely, get the ball out as quick as possible, and again, go pick up 9 free yards. Basically, you want to play 10 yards off at the snap because you're terrified of us beating you deep. Well, we'll take the 9 yards. Easy money. Get ahead of the sticks. 154. Now, those are easy concepts, right? He's always been able to do it. How about this one? Boom, get the ball out quick. We're really, really helping our quarterback out at this point. We've thrown one ball past 5 yards, and it's a hitch route, essentially. Okay. Jermaine Burton was electric all night. We'll be talking about him, obviously. Getting out on the edge. Two guys getting key blocks. Look at this. Boom. Kiaris. I mean, he got blown up, but guess what? His guy didn't make the tackle. Pickens, okay. What I like about this, though, is that he's at least playing physical, right? He's at least sticking his nose in there. Now, could he have brought his feet? Yeah, he could have. But he's at least sticking his nose in there and playing physical. I like to see that. from a wide receiver early on in the football game, helping his guys get ahead early. Where are we going next? All right, 217. The very next pass attempt after a run for a first down. Boom, back to the hitch. Okay, five throws in a row. First five throws in the game. Let's get him comfortable. Let's get him nice and loose. And then, you know, when we flip back and get the ball back, or when we flip at the end of the quarter, we're going to let him take a shot, okay? And he's going to take it on a little corner route right here, a little further. Now we're stretching him out a little further, right? Through inside five, inside five, inside five, okay? Let's give him a 15-yard little corner route with one of our best slot receivers, best route runners on the football team. Look at this. Boom, look at him create space. Offensive pass interference, maybe. Look at that ball, okay? Five, 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 15, okay? Next ball, I believe, 319. Oh, this was never any doubt. We're just going to skip the batted down balls. This was never a question, right? We showed you on the run, the boy was nice with it. And he is right there. Again, anticipatory throw. We talk about those all the time. They're very, very important down here when space gets tight really, really quickly. Okay, he throws that ball, if there's a replay on here, he throws that ball before Pickens actually turns all the way back around. I think we do get a replay right here. Okay, getting out on the edge, getting him moving to his right where he feels comfortable. We didn't get to see Pickens, but look at the ball placement. Can't be anywhere else but that right there. We showed you that one last week too. Okay, he's got it. He's got it in spades. He's special. Consistent now is the scary part. And I hear a lot of people say, well, Brooks, who cares? Who cares about the mechanics? Who cares? If he just gets the ball there and gives his guy a chance, isn't that worth it? Yeah, it is worth it. But here's the deal. This right here, this pop step where we're falling back, critically underthrown football. Now, great play. We gave our wide receiver a chance. We just got, you know, 40 yards in the air when all year, think about it, all year, what have I been saying on these false starts or, you know, offsides from the defense? Take the daggum shot. It is a free play. Take the shot. Guess what he does? He takes the shot and he completes it. Okay. But it's underthrown. Okay. First deep ball, though, right? Still getting his feet wet. Now we're throwing the ball deep. Now we're driving the ball down the field. I'm ahead of my notes somehow. At least he's giving his guys a shot. That's what I love. Could it have been a touchdown? Is the next one a touchdown? Yes. Are the mechanics a little bit better on the next one? Yes. Is it better than anything Georgia's had all season by far? Yes. Am I nitpicking at this point? You get it. You got it. All right? Let's get to our next clips. Going to 451. Look, I like that. This is a sack, but I like this pocket movement. Watch him. For a guy who hadn't been inside the bullets for a while, look at him just dodging people. First of all, terrible job here on the twist. Y'all going to see this one all night. Awful job here on the twist. They send the defensive tackle out, a game stunt, send number three back in. Watch Ben. Ben takes way too long to get back to the twister, and now all of a sudden JT pops up. Gets his feet back set, tries to work back left, but he's already compromised, sacked. Okay, but I like that right there, okay? Kept two hands on the ball. Watch him. Let's slow it down real nice. Kept two hands on the ball, kept his eyes downfield, and nice, tight footwork. Watch him. Whoop. Steps back up, gets his eyes back on somebody. Now, could he have probably gotten rid of the ball? Maybe. But I'm not going to sit here when bullets are flying like that in your first game. I'm more impressed by the original, you know, ability to make a guy miss with your eyes downfield. That's veteran type stuff right there. That's what you work on all summer. .459. Third and 17 right here after the sack. Completely okay with this play call. All right. You're the ball's at what? The 38-yard line. So 7 yards, a 53-yard field goal. Right, 38, balls, the holder's at the 43, 10 yards in the end zone. It's a 53-yard field goal from right there. Podlesny might be able to hit that, but we'd be better off giving him another 9 yards. So let's get a nice little screen pass and get off the field. Okay, let's get 3 points, get off the field. I'm totally okay with that play call right there. .517. All right, here's the ball to Jermaine, right? This is an absolute dime. Okay, we're going to show you this ball. See how he got through that ball? Slow it down just a little bit. We're going to show you this, and we're going to show you the very first deep ball he threw. Okay, watch this one. This ball is completed in stride, an absolute dime. Okay? Still jumped a little bit, but got through the football. A nice follow through. Boom. Dropped right into the basket, right? Watch the other one. Back at 357. Okay? This one on the passing or on the offsides, we don't quite get into this ball all the way. Okay? See how we're just kind of leaning back? We're jumping up in the air. Feet aren't really in the ground. The timing was just a tad bit off, right? We're splitting hairs at this point. But when all is right, when he does it correctly, okay, when he times this thing up perfectly with this pop step in his front foot, it's electric. He throws one of the best deep balls in the game. Okay? Or he will continue to throw one of the best deep balls in the game. Watch this. Gets through that football. Gets on top of it. Doesn't jump. Doesn't look like he's jumping backwards at the point of release. More jumping upwards. Ball's not on the throw. Ball's thrown in a perfect spot for his guy and his guy only.